Y'all come on down and let's do some biz.
Cause everybody else is.
Restrictions apply. See dealer for details.
Up to 6,000 off 2017 Explorers during the summer savings event at Lightbridge Ford in Blackshear. No high pressure, just honest savings and more for your trade. Stop the surge. Call Lightbridge or go to LightbridgeFord.com. Right on the corner and right on the price.
WIFO 105.5 FM in Jessup, Big Dog Country Radio. Good morning, Butch Shepherd here with you on this Monday morning. Monday morning, we do appreciate you tuning in. All right, it's now time for the world famous Butch and Bob Show, brought to you by Mike Birch Ford in Blackshear, by Jessup Premium Stores located out here on the Waycross Highway, by Republic Services, and by Murphy Builder Supply located on Northeast Broad Street in downtown Jessup. Bob, we got a studio full this morning. Who do we have in here this morning?
Yes,
we got the U8 baseball team, is that right? U10, U8. U8 baseball team in this morning, recreation team, right? All right, okay, let me cut the mics on here. That would help. All right, we got the U8 baseball team, recreation baseball team this morning. We got a bunch of young gentlemen in here this morning, standing back there, ready to go on the air. They got their big Wayne black t-shirts on with the black and gray sleeves on them. We got the coaches in here, four coaches. And why don't, since Bob and I don't know everybody, go ahead and introduce yourself.
I'm Jonathan Scott.
Jonathan Scott, and you are the head coach of this team, right?
Yes, sir.
And you've got three assistants here with you. You just go ahead and introduce them, then we'll go around to them. No, you just go ahead and introduce them.
All right, we got Russell Hilton, Jesse Scott, Alan Hickox.
Okay, and tell us about the U8 baseball team. I know y'all wanted to be on the air this morning. Tell us a little about the team and what's going on with the team.
Well, we're headed out to South Haven, Mississippi. We're leaving tomorrow morning to go play in the Dizzy Dean World Series.
You are? Now, this is the only team going out there, or is there other teams?
No, we actually have two going this year.
And who's the other team?
Kyle Wilkerson is coaching. Kyle Wilkerson and Chris Banks are coaching another 8U team.
Oh, so there's two U18 going on. Is that for that age group out there, then, U18?
It's big for Dizzy Dean, but they have it from, 16 and under?
Oh, so they do have other teams out there, okay? So we could send another team if we wanted to.
We actually do have another 12U team going, too. Bobby Lamb's coaching that one.
Thursday games we're doing this week when we get there Thursday.
Okay, so we're doing the U12 team.
We're doing the 10 and 12 team.
10 and 12 team. 10, 11, and 12-year-old. But Bob will be there in Mississippi with y'all, so he'll be keeping updated with the
guys. Hopefully they're still in it. There's no conflict. We're working all that out, but we're not. My trip's not till Thursday.
Till Thursday.
I'll be out there earlier than we will get there.
All right. So we will be carrying the 10, 11, and 12-year-old games right here on WIFO. And if things work out, maybe we can, if y'all are still playing, maybe we can do y'all too. But we'll definitely be there, and he can keep up with the scores, and Bob can give you a cell phone number, and y'all can exchange cell phone numbers, and we can keep up and keep people reported on the U8 baseball team. Out there. And tell us a little bit about the Dizzy Dean tournament. What is that? Where is it held? And why are you going?
It's held in South Haven, Mississippi. And we changed, changeover last year to Dizzy Dean. And we sent a team last year that did really well. They finished, I think, in the top four.
And okay. They finished in the top four?
They kind of paved the way for us to go.
Okay.
It's new to us.
When is your first game?
Our first game will be Thursday.
And y'all leaving and when?
We leave tomorrow morning.
Tomorrow morning.
We have a opening ceremonies and all kind of things for the kids to do.
Okay.
They'll participate in. They got pin trading, little push pins that they'll trade with teams and things like that. And then they have a parade that they'll go and get introduced. And
all right. And so we'll have a parade through the town there?
They have an amphitheater there set up just for that.
Just for that. Right. Okay. Well, let's go around and talk to the coaches a little bit. Let's go to, introduce yourself, please.
Hey, I'm Russell Hilton.
Russell Hilton. And how long have you been coaching the boys?
Well, the All-Star team, I've actually been coaching ever since my little one's been four. But the All-Stars, we actually, most of us coached, all of us coached again last year together. On the All-Star team,
okay.
The B team, and now this year we've got the A team this year.
Okay.
With the kids are a little bit older this year, so we're just looking forward to it to get out there and make some noise.
Now, you eight, how low does that go in terms of age?
You can actually, the way things are set up in recreation now is you can play up. So you can have them younger than
you can
eight,
have any you know,
seven,
eight,
six, seven,
okay.
8 year olds.
Just like the 10, 11, 12 year olds are going out there and there. Well, you got a poster. Is that anything important
right
there?
We actually have a sponsor's poster.
A sponsor's poster?
You know, that we've.
All right, if you would do them a favor, if y'all talk to two coaches that hold it right here, and if you see, we have a live video feed going on right now. And when we say live, it's about 30 seconds behind. The camera is right there. Okay? So just hold that up, okay? If you hold up just this end out here on the left end, you can hold up a little higher. There you go. There is a sponsor's banner, and y'all will hang that out there at
yes,
at the field when you're there
playing? If they allow us to do it, we're going to hang it on the dugout.
Okay.
While we're out there.
All right, that's a good-looking poster right there with all the sponsors on there, and I'm sure the sponsors help y'all with your expenses going out there and everything, right?
Tremendously,
huh? All right, you can go ahead and set it back down then. And so, see, you can see it up there on the screen now. All right, let's move on to the next coach here. Let's go down to this end down here. Go ahead and introduce yourself.
My name is Alan Hickox.
Alan Hickox, you got a boy playing?
I do, AJ.
AJ's playing. Yes, all right, and how long have you been coaching?
I've been coaching, again, we coached last year together. Coached all year, coached football and all that. I've been coaching baseball now, I guess, about four years.
Okay, all right, did you play when you were a youngster?
Yes, sir, I graduated in 2004.
Okay. All right, Wayne County?
Yes, sir.
All right, let's go around to the next coach right here. Introduce yourself.
Jesse Scott.
Jesse Scott, you got a boy playing?
I do. Owen Scott.
Okay, did you play when you were younger?
I sure did.
All right, Wayne County or somewhere else?
I played Wayne County.
Wayne County, what year did you graduate?
02.
All right, you graduated the same year my youngest son did, Chad Hubbard.
I did, I went to school with Chad.
Yeah, you did. Okay. All right, so what we got to do is we've talked to the four coaches, got them to introduce yourselves. Now, what we're going to do now, if you would move your mic up this way and out a little bit and about the height they are, maybe just a hair higher. All right. Will it stay up? Let's get that higher. If it'll stay, okay, you can move that way. What we want to do is let you introduce yourself, tell us who your parents are, say your name, your parents, and what position you play, okay? Go ahead.
My name is Gavin Hilton, and my dad is...
Right there?
Yeah. And I play shortstop.
And you play shortstop?
And left center.
All right. Your dad and mom's names.
He's Russell.
Uh-huh.
And my mama's Charla.
Okay, sounds good. And you play what position again?
Shortstop and left center.
Okay, all right. Move on back and let's do the next one. He's got something he wants to read? Go ahead, read that. Go ahead.
I want to thank Mickey's Farm, Omaha Motors, and Sold Services Incorporated.
All right. Okay, everyone's got somebody to thank there. Okay, I see your cards there. Okay, introduce yourself.
I am Gunnar Campbell.
And your parents are?
Gordy and Brooke Campbell.
All righty. What position do you play?
Pitcher.
Pitcher. All right. Do you throw the heat?
Not really.
So does it play? So you, what kind of, what's your favorite pitch? What do you get most guys out with?
It's coach pitch.
Oh, it's a pitching thing. Okay. So you just stand there with the coach and it's a pitching machine. Okay. All right. Tell us who do you want to thank?
Mallards.
Sigma Tank Service.
Sigma Tank Service. Dr. Paul Scott. Dents Cabinet Doors.
All right. Sounds good. Okay. Move on back and let's have the next player come up. Come on up. Don't be shy. All right. What's your name?
My name's Eli. My mom is Courtney, and my daddy's Caleb, and I play third and left center.
And what's your last name?
Grantham.
Grantham, did you have anything you want to read?
I would like to thank HDI Power Construction, Lewis Contracting, Universal Electric, and Boykin Erectors.
Okay, sounds good. You got it right. All right, let's move on to the next player here. Who do we have? All right, come on up. Your name?
Cohen Tyre.
Once again?
Cohen Tyre.
And your parents are?
Samantha Jacobs and Josh Tyre.
Okay, and what position do you play?
Second base.
All righty, and who do you want to thank?
I want to thank Bicy Colson.
Bicy Collision.
Bicy Collision. Mike Swelding. Maintenance.
Okay.
Samantha Jacobs, PC, Audrey at Law.
Okay, all right. And these are the sponsors who are thanking the people who are helping pay for their trip out there to Mississippi for the Dizzy Dean Tournament. You're listening to WIFO-FM and Jessup World Famous Butch and Bob Show. We have the U8 baseball team that's heading to Mississippi to the Dizzy Dean Tournament out there. And so let's move on to the next player. Who do we have?
My name is Owen Scott. My parents are Jesse and Rebecca Scott.
And who do you want to thank?
I want to thank Wayne Sheet Metal Fabrication.
Okay.
Jolin W. Purple.
Attorney.
Attorney.
Okay.
At Law. Robert Wynn, Wayne County Sheriff's Office.
All right, sounds good. Let's move on to the next player here. Who do we have up next? All right, your name, please.
My name is Max Boykin.
And who are your parents?
Sylvia Boykin and Jimbo Boykin.
Okay, and what position do you play?
I also play left center and third base.
Okay, and who do you want to thank?
I want to thank the Interstate Credit Union.
Union. Interstate Credit Union.
Sorry.
Somebody didn't write that down right. Look, I know it's set up a U, right? Okay.
Kimberly A. Roster, CPA.
Okay.
Serenity Brothers Stomping.
All right. I want to thank all those sponsors there for helping us out and get these boys out to Mississippi. Who's up next?
My name is Brenton Ray.
And who are your parents?
Ann Ray and Donnie Ray.
And who do you? What position do you play?
I play right field.
And who do you want to thank?
I want to thank Rogers Transport, and Jessup Tire Shop, and Bark M. Clark.
Okay. All right. Who do we have? Who's our next player up here from this UA baseball team heading to the Dizzy Dean Tournament in Mississippi? Who's next?
I'm Trey Ogden, and my parents are Jonathan Scott and Kara Scott. And
what position do you play?
I play, which is right center.
Right center. And who do you want to thank this morning? The self-sponsoring y'all.
Jessup Drive-In, Starling Farm, and Land Clearing, Airy State Lost Team.
Okay, who's our next player? All right, your name?
AJ.
AJ what?
Hickox.
AJ Hickox, and who are your parents?
I have a day.
Okay, who's your mom? What'd you say? Okay. And what position do you play?
First
base. And who do you want to thank this morning?
Mark, Amy, Fry, Yoder, Metal, Jessup, JC's.
Yep. Okay, Jessup, JC's. Okay. All right. Do we have, who's next? Clayton. Okay, who do we have here? What's your name?
Clayton Blocker.
Clayton Blocker, and your parents are?
Heather and Michael Blocker.
And what position do you play?
Right center.
Right center. And who do you want to thank this morning? Who's one of some of the sponsors?
R&R Auto Sales, Adam General Store,
Airco
Power Service.
Okay, Airco Power Service. All right. Do we have another one? Here we go. Your name?
Aiden Graham.
And who are your parents?
Lisa Graham and Ethan Graham.
And what position do you play?
Left center and left.
And who do you want to thank this morning?
Mr. Cash, Pawn Shop, Vans Auto, Power Service, and the Power Services Group.
All right. And do we have another player? Here we go.
Hello, my name is Wyatt Hickox, and my parents are Jamie and Ralph Hickox. I play catcher, and I'd like to thank Christine's Reality Company, Altamaha Federal Credit Union, and Albert Howard.
All right. Any more? Did we get all of them? That's it. All right, guys. Sounds good. And so y'all going to leave tomorrow morning going out to, what's the name of the town once again? Hey, y'all want to move that on around? There you go.
South Haven, Mississippi.
South Haven, Mississippi. Now, if a person was looking up South Haven, Mississippi on a map, where would that be in Mississippi?
North Mississippi, almost in Tennessee.
Almost in Tennessee? Is it right next to the Mississippi River?
15 minutes from Memphis, Arkansas, Tennessee.
Okay, so it's right about 15 minutes south of Memphis, Tennessee. Okay, so y'all got quite a ways to go, don't you?
10 hours.
10 hours. Are you taking different cars?
Yeah, we're all riding separate.
That's all riding separate. All the parents will be heading up there having a good old time. Y'all got, you know, rooms all lined up.
Got rooms lined up. Everything's ready to go, just waiting on us.
Okay, so you get up there tomorrow, and you got opening ceremonies on Wednesday, is that right?
Opening ceremonies on Wednesday.
Y'all get any practice time in?
Yeah, we'll be able to get some practice in there. They have a nice indoor hitting facility that we can rent out hour at a time, take them up there,
okay,
practice them.
And when's your first game?
We're doing the bracket and everything. We're going to draw Wednesday.
Okay. Is it a double elimination?
They do a pool play. I think you get four games in the pool play, and then you go to a double elimination.
So you definitely play four games.
We definitely play four.
Okay, and let's say, does it matter if you win all four or don't win them by the time you get the next round?
I'm gonna say it does matter.
It does matter. Okay,
that's what we're shooting for.
That's what you're shooting for. So they guarantee you four games because you know a lot of teams got a long way to go, so right. They want to get those games in, and y'all have all the pickings when you get out there to find out, you know, who you play, what time, and all that kind of stuff, right?
That's right.
Okay, and this is the first time any of these boys, have they been on a big trip like this before?
We actually have two that went last year.
Okay, two that went last year.
Max Boykin and Eli Grantham.
Okay.
This will be their second time.
Okay, so the U8 team from Wayne County going up to play in the Dizzy Dean Tournament. We got another U8 team going, right, you said?
That's right.
And we got a U12 team going that we will be broadcasting the games from up there in Mississippi during the Dizzy Dean Tournament. Bob will be up there on Thursday. We'll broadcast the games. If y'all could exchange cell phone numbers somehow, and that way he can keep up with y'all and y'all, what y'all doing, where you're at, you know, who you're playing, and how you're doing each one of the games, okay?
Sounds good. I think they're all going to be at the same complex.
Same complex.
Yeah,
okay.
They have a really big complex there.
All right. Well, when he's in one certain area, he can't be all the way over somewhere else. So if someone could just be a runner or let him know what's going on, because we'd like everyone to know here in the Wayne County area what's going on with the team, okay?
Sounds good.
All right. Well, appreciate y'all coming in this morning. Safe travels to Mississippi. Good luck, boys, and bring home the trophy, okay? First place trophy. All right. Anything else y'all wanted to say? Is that it? WIFO 105.5 FM and Jessup, Big Dog Country Radio. The time you're listening to the world famous Butch and Bob Show is 8:16. We'll be back more of the world famous Butch and Bob Show in a moment. Piggly Wiggly offers you super specials every week to help save you money. Here are just a few of the meat specials at Piggly Wiggly. Fresh ground beef, just $1.98 a pound. Fresh Boston butt pork roast, $1.38 a pound. Boneless, skinless chicken breast, only $1.98 a pound. 18-piece fresh chicken pack, below 98 cents a pound. T-bone steaks, $5.98 a pound. And cube beef steaks, only $3.98 a pound. The best meats, the best prices. Piggly Wiggly in Jessup. Also on sale at Piggly Wiggly, red or green seedless grapes, sale priced at 98 cents a pound. Juicy peaches, $1.69 a pound. Piggly Wiggly large eggs, 88 cents a dozen. Pet ice cream, buy one, get one free. Vidalia onions, get 2 3-pound bags for only $5. And red delicious apples, only 89 cents a pound. Low prices, the best service. Piggly Wiggly, 440 West Cherry Street in Jessup, open 7 days a week from 7 a.m. to 10 p.m. 105.5 FM in Jessup, Big Dog Country Radio, WIFO, world famous Butch and Bob Show, Monday morning. It is the 17th day of July. Bob, well, three teams out there at the Dizzy Dean Tournament up there in Mississippi.
Yeah, three teams. I say we're going out there to do the 10 to 12, but if we get out there and there other eight teams are still in there and there's no conflict, we'll hopefully do some of those games. But we don't get there till Thursday. And like I said, they're opening ceremonies Friday. I don't think their tournament starts till Saturday. So.
Also, the U10 team?
I don't have all that information to talk to y'all. I'm getting all that information today. Okay. I said we had all these state recreation teams last week, plus the Piranhas. So we had to get through all that. Now we're concentrating on this trip to Mississippi this week, but okay. We're still organizing, getting it sold and everything like that.
Right.
So
we'll let you know. Bob will let you know on the sportscast and here on the world famous Butch and Bob Show exactly the first game of the U12 team and when we'll be broadcasting and all that kind of good stuff there, letting you know what's going on out there in Mississippi with these three teams going to the Dizzy Dean tournament there. The teams come in all from all over the country, or is it mainly a Southeast?
It's all over the country.
All over the country.
And I said, you got to qualify to get to these tournaments that our new 12 won this, our tournament, which we held here. They wanted to qualify.
They qualified, so. Yeah. And speaking of winners, we won a state championship over the weekend, didn't we?
Yeah, junior boys won as we expected, and then several state champions in swimming. So a great showing by the Piranhas and the state swim meet. So it's good to see all those state champions come back from Tifton. So again, with a no pool.
Imagine what we'd do if we had a pool.
So just a great showing by the Piranhas up there. So
okay.
Very talented swimmers. So.
Well, congratulations to the Piranhas and the junior all-star team there. A lot of state championships there, and Bob has a complete report on those on his sportscast, which will be midday today, right around 12:30, and then later this afternoon, right around 5:25. So you can tune in hear that, or you can go to our website at BigDogCountry.com. Well, no, that's just news on BigDogCountry.com. The sportscast will be around 12:30 midday and around 5:25 this afternoon, right after when local news here on 105.5 FM, Big Dog Country, WIFO. Well, the Braves looked good over the weekend, didn't they?
Yeah, Braves won all three games, which is good.
Yeah, you know, we gave away those four tickets on Friday morning to Friday night's game, and the guy that called in, him and three of his buddies, were going to get on their motorcycles and their bikes and head up there and watch the game, and they got to see a good victory by the Braves. So hope they had a good time up there in Atlanta at the Atlanta Braves baseball game. And I'm sure they enjoyed that new SunTrust Park up there. And I'm looking forward to go to my first game up there at the SunTrust next month sometime. And so we got a couple of important meetings going on tonight, right?
Tomorrow night. City meets tomorrow. The school board meets tomorrow. No meeting tonight.
Okay, no meeting tonight, but school board and city tomorrow night with their regular meetings, but one of them has a work session, right?
City's got a work session 5, meeting at 7.
Okay. All right. And anything on your mind this morning, anything that happened over the weekend or going on this week that you want to highlight in any type of way?
Like I said, just a busy time of year. Again, congrats to the junior boys all-star team and congrats to the Piranhas who had a nice showing up in Tifton. I said a lot of first-place finishers, a lot of second-place finishers, third-place finishers. So just a lot of talented swimmers did well. It's hard to win a state championship, but they brought several home.
Isn't that something? That is great by the Piranhas. And like we mentioned, if we just imagine what these kids could do if they had their regular pool to go to, instead of having to borrow one here and borrow one there, and people stand around and have to wait for another swimmer to get through practicing. So hopefully that pool situation here for Wayne County will be taken care of by the city and the county and the school board, whoever's involved, and get that 8-lane facility just like Tifton has done here so we can start hosting events and have it our swimmers have a full practice pool. Just imagine what they could do if they had a pool that their own where they could practice all the time and not have to worry about borrowing somebody's smaller pool in the backyard. All right, 105.5 FM and Jeff's the Big Dog Country, WIFO. And college football is just around the corner. Some people are picking Georgia to win the East. Is that right?
Yeah, the SEC media picked Georgia and Alabama, but they got it right 1 out of 50 times.
So. Not a good track record.
Not a good track record on SEC media picking the winners. So they don't pick it very often. So they did select Georgia over Florida in the East, which is interesting because most people used to take Florida because their home schedule. They got most of their SEC games at home this year. So it'll come down, as it always does, to Georgia, Florida, down in Jacksonville. Yeah. Normally that's what it comes down to between these two wins that game, down in Jacksonville. So hopefully Georgia can win that game. Hopefully get off to a good start. But as I said, big question marks quarterback play. Talent everywhere. The question is, can the quarterback be consistent? Can he be a leader? Can he step up from last year? Can he learn the playbook? That'll be a start.
Yeah, well, he was very inconsistent last year. I don't know if Coach Kirby decided, well, we're just going to put him in there and let him get that experience under his belt as I build this team the way that I want it built and coach the way I want it coached. So we have that experience for this year. We'll find out once Easton gets on the field.
That the offensive line, like I said, the offensive line's got a lot of recruits came in. The question is how quick do they get on the field because they got some massive recruits.
That's a kid from New York. Big guys up there, huh?
Speculation is by the third, fourth game, you'll see three or four freshmen on the offensive line.
Oh, wow.
Which would probably be a good thing. They probably need to be there game one, but...
Nobody feels. I didn't think they care about that in sports. Not in that level. Yeah. Not in the college level. Somebody just texted in, city will review the interim financials tomorrow. Why doesn't the county issue interim financials? Do you have any idea, Bob? I think that might be a question that's above Bob's pay grade.
Right.
Have no idea. All right. He doesn't know, folks. He doesn't know. He's not in the know on all that kind of stuff. But the school board and the city meeting tomorrow night, and Bob will have a report on those on Wednesday and Thursday. And so the Georgia Bulldogs, by certain folks, are predicted to be the winner of the East. Florida is also in there. But what on the other side, you've got Alabama, which is, you know, a pretty easy pick over there on the west side.
Everybody picks Alabama. They're predicted to be the number one team in the country, so...
Okay. Now, are they talking about bringing two more teams into the SEC? Have you heard about that?
I have not.
You have not? Yeah, talking about bringing two more teams in there and doing realignment. And, you know, some folks are talking about, well, Auburn needs to be over in the East. And some folks say, heck no, you don't want Auburn East. You still want them in the West. So it'll give that Iron Bowl game even more of meaning. I don't know, Bob. You know, they're just talking about different things there that could kind of mess up. If you listen to Chuck Oliver, he talks about it, and it could really mess up some traditions and what people are used to, and you know, with the fans balk and all that.
The big story in Athens is the heat on the athletic director. Former players wrote a big article how the facilities and the programs just aren't where they should be, including teams that used to dominate, like the men's tennis and women's gymnastics, and the list goes on and on.
Oh, yeah, we
Georgia
used to
baseball
dominate all
programs
the time.
That, there's a scathing article written by a former player who's, I mean, he's just crushes Greg McGarrity, but McGarrity's been under the fire for the last couple of years, so people curious how he survives, but I said this with this article and all the, I mean, it's just fact after fact after fact.
Yeah, the facts are there. It just wasn't a made up rant rave type
the
article.
The facilities aren't where they should be. The programs aren't where they should be. They're not competitive. Georgia baseball program for the last several years has not been competitive. So,
did he inherit all that? Has he done anything so far to change it around?
I just know that there's a lot of people happy with Mr. McGarrity. So, so we'll see how that plays out in the next, you know, couple of months, couple of years, whatever. But that's the big story in Athens. If you read that article, it's just very informative and very eye-opening on how bad the overall program really is.
It's in the Atlanta Journal-Constitution?
I believe it's on the Georgia website.
On the Georgia website, okay.
Somebody sent it to me over the weekend, but it was a very interesting read.
Okay.
A former baseball player who played at Georgia, you know, when they had some success at baseball. That's basically his angle. He's very upset with the facility and the program and how it's just not being competitive at all.
Well, we remember, you know, Georgia used to dominate in gymnastics and swimming and stuff like that. I thought we had a pretty good swim. I mean, it's a nice facility up there in that big athletic.
I just didn't realize the tennis program had fallen. When I was there, tennis was it. I still remember going at McEnroe up there in the days. That was fun. That's a long-haired kid from Stanford.
He was from Stanford, huh?
Yeah, we gave him... He didn't care because he won his match, but it was just fun to give him a hard time that day.
What year was that?
78, 79, something like
that. So you got to see him up there at the complex?
Yeah, he came in, and that was a big event back in the day. So I was there, tennis was huge. I mean, Dan McGill had the tennis program just rolling, but they used to always host a SEC event, and they would host the national events as well. And like I said, Stanford came in there. Old McEnroe, I think, was either a sophomore or a freshman, but he was as good as advertised.
Was he?
But
did he have the temper then? Did he have the personality?
Oh, he just was arrogant as all.
Oh, arrogant.
he gave as well as he took. as much as we dished out,
he gave it right back. And he had long hair about then.
Was it long, straight, or was it curly? It was kind of like a big old afro.
Yeah, that's the way his hair grows. It's like
a headband, but.
But you got to see him in person there when he was in college.
He was awfully good, though.
He was good, huh?
Yeah, but that was a memorable event. But as I said, I just remember tennis being...
Oh, it was big. It was big. It was really big back then. I mean, just about, a lot of folks played tennis back then. Speaking of tennis, at the Wimbledon, it finished up. The old man, they call him, age 36, and they call him an old man, Roger Federer won his 8th Wimbledon title.
Yeah. I said the guy he played against had a foot injury, didn't really compete much, but just went to the entire event, though, without losing a set. So that was...
That is good.
It was interesting. He took like 6 months off before he started this year, and he's won 2 majors. So I asked if he's going to take more time off. He said probably needs to take more time off. So, he has 2 sets of twins. He has twin girls and twin boys. So,
So, man.
18th major, or it's not, I'm sorry, 19th major is 8th Wimbledon. Has more Wimbledon titles than anybody else.
Even Jan Borg, born him, huh?
Yeah. So, it was fun to watch Sunday.
Okay. Well, Bob, we're out of time.
Okay.
Have a good day. World Famous Butch and Bob Show brought to you by Murphy Builder Supply on Northeast Broad Street in downtown Jessup, by Republic Services, by Jessup Premium Storage out here on the Waycross Highway in Jessup, and by Mike Birch Ford in Blackshear. The time now is 8:30. Let's check.